speaking this morning with Peter Harold from Poseidon Nickel. Peter, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
Oh, good result here, Pete. $9 million. Tell us a bit, firstly, about the capital raise here.
Yeah, well, we've been ably assisted by Morgan's brokers who have been following this stock for quite a while. And it's a $6 million placement. And then we're going to top it up with an SPP, which will give us, close to $9 million, which is fantastic.
So what does it mean, Pete, for Poseidon Nickel and your plans?
Yeah, well, it's good because what it means is we've got plenty of cash now to get through to Q2 next year. And that's obviously when we want to make the decision to proceed, whether it's through the 1.1 million tonne per annum high-grade concentrate route, or it's the 2.2 million tonne per annum case where we go to what we call the rougher concentrate, which is a lower-grade nickel, but probably, significantly more tonnes of contained nickel through a different product into a POX plant or an HPAL. So we want to make the call on one or the other in second quarter of next year. We've also got some drilling to do down at Lake Johnston. We're really excited about the potential down there, which is our other project. And really importantly too, we've got some drilling starting in the base of the open pit at Black Swan in about a week and a half's time. We're just clearing out the bottom of that, just all the muck and stuff out of the bottom. We've got some rigs, two rigs booked to come in, and hopefully that'll increase the reserve by, we reckon, an extra year on the base case feasibility. So take it from 4 to a 5 year project. So all things that'll add significant value to the business.
So have you kicked off some of the pre-production works?
Yeah, look, we have. And one of the points we raised in the with regard to the funds for the raising is there are some long lead items. There's a variable speed drive system for the SAG mill, which is about a 40-week delivery time ex-Asia. So it's something like that we can place an order for straight away. And there's obviously some deposit money that's got to be paid. So you can place those orders with confidence, which is important too.
And so you say, looking near term, one of the big boxes to tick is the FID first half next year, is it?
Yes. Yeah, correct, Andrew. Yeah, so we really want to be in a situation, we've obviously been, talking about starting up for a long time, and we've had some delays due to, COVID and all the combination of getting people and getting assay results. I mean, obviously, one of the big things has been the metallurgical breakthrough that we've had with regard to the high-grade concentrate. That was something that was a real issue for us previously in regard to the fact that when Norilsk stopped production in 2009, they could see this problem coming. And in fact, they were producing concentrate that had an iron Mg ratio of less than 2 to 1, which is a really difficult concentrate to sell. So they were seeing this problem coming ahead and had been doing some work. But we've really, what I'd like to say, cracked the code on this, and our metallurgical project director, Dave Naxton, who's a metallurgist, has really come up with a novel way of doing this and mixing the tailings and also some of the high grade and using the Silver Swan old mill as a regrind mill. This is very clever stuff, and he should certainly get a pat on the back for the work that he's done here. And it's really a game changer for the 1.1 million tonne concentrate case. And as a result of that, we've had very, very strong interest from the market, directly from smelters, but also from traders. Mm. And the payabilities we've received are well in excess of what you would have been able to achieve previously. I mean, I've been in this business for 30 years. I've not seen payabilities at this sort of level ever. And it's a function of the quality of the product, but also the market. It's very tight for concentrates. And so people are bidding up, these higher payabilities to get hold of quality concentrate. So that's a real key. Notwithstanding that, the 2.2 million tonne case for us is exciting too, because there's, previously no one sort of really looked at these low grade, 6-7% concentrates with high MgO, because they would have been difficult to sell. But there's much more of a market opening up now with people building pressure oxidation plants, the ability to take some of this material in an HPAL plant. So really exciting opportunities. And, there's potentially, a much bigger mine plan if we go to that 2.2 million tonne case. So longer mine life, more tonnes per nickel per year. So nice options to have. And we've got to make a call, whether we go starting off on the concentrate that's saleable for, as we call a conventional nickel concentrate, for a few years, and then go into the 2.2, or go straight to the 2.2. And all of these things need to be considered. And this funding allows us to, you know, to have time to make those, you know, decisions. But we do want to be in a position to press the button in the second quarter of next year.
Just finally, Pete, speaking of the market, how's the vibe within the nickel space at the moment?
Oh, it's incredible. You know, I mean, notwithstanding the markets are a bit choppy, you know, the demand for nickel that is unabatedly growing, and we're seeing lots of inbound interest from, you know, all the various players, plus private equity, plus corporates, plus car manufacturers. So you can see that there's, that, you know, there's a growing interest in the space, and I think it's only just the tip of the iceberg in terms of where prices could go and where, you know, interest for the product and the business could go. So look, this funding really helps us to get us to that decision point, and that's critical. So really appreciate the efforts by Morgans and also by existing shareholders and new shareholders who've contributed to the raise.
Good to see you, Pete. Thanks for your time.
Thanks again, Andrew. Cheers.